Okay, so I want to do a bit of a talk about the 1980s, and I get this. Just pages and pages of what I've remembered, and some stuff from movies and a BBC documentary. What can I say about the 1980s? At the time, it seemed everything seemed completely normal, but in retrospect, it was a really quite a different and exciting type of time. Of course, it should really go without saying, but I'll say it anyway. This is my view. You don't have to agree. I respect your right to disagree or have different thoughts about what I say. And this is entirely my own personal memories and view of the 1980s. This work is inspired by the BBC program The Grumpy Guide to the 80s. And the material that I've researched, or the movie I've watched, is and the movie I recommend if you want to understand the 1980s is Voyage of the Rock Aliens. Voyage of the Rock Aliens, and I believe that was made in 1984. The 1980s was a good time for me. I was 17. I just got my motorbike license in 1984. I'd grown up in a city and I'd moved to the country, but I had my motorcycle and you know, things were just starting to really happen for me. The 1980s new wave turned out to be indestructible in the long run. It survived the negative 90s and it's now seen for what it was, and that's freedom. So I believe that I've got enough just from memory and watching the BBC program and Voyage of the Rock Aliens to have more than enough material for a show. So this is how I intend to do this talk. I've got all this material, and I thought what I'd do is read it out, all the subjects and things I remember as I wrote them down, and I'll refer to the computer for pictures. The first thing about the 80s I remembered was shoulder pads. The females used to wear shoulder pads, and they used to come right out to here. And of course, another big fashion were the sort of the vest looking like a great big bib that babies wear, just sort of what do you call it, sort of a leather type thing that came down here with buttons. Perms were very popular, males and females, sometimes called big hair, where it was all sort of buffed out. And tips is fashion in the 80s that isn't really talked about. So you get the end of your hair and you put bleach on it or whatever they use, probably not bleach, and just do the very ends of each strand, and that would create a tip. You know, you would say you had your tips done. Expensive CDs. Now, at the time, an album used to cost about $15, and then CDs came out and they went straight up to sort of $40, so from $15 to $40. And what that meant was, in around about 1983-84, especially 84, you could no longer purchase the albums. So the type of music you were following, you just unless you were working and earning good money, you were completely cut off, disconnected from that, you know, from your music and buying albums. Needless to say, I've got a big tape collection, but no CDs from the 80s. One interesting thing was I was in Victoria in the 1980s, and they had a law which said you could only do 80 kilometres an hour if you were a learner on a motorcycle. Now, you got out on the open road where there's one lane, and there were plenty of one-lane expressways in those days, and you had all sorts of trucks and cars right on your backside riding a motorcycle. Of course, the mullet was huge in the 80s. You know, a star or a sportsman would just turn up on TV with his mullet. Hey, everybody, you know, Thingo's got a mullet. And yeah, that was the big surprise about that person, that he'd always wanted a mullet, and there he was in all his glory. Now, here's one thing about the 80s. That when you tell people, they can't believe it, and they say, my God, that's right. They were more interested in finding poofters than terrorists. I'll say that again. They were more interested in finding poofters than terrorists. And that was the times that you lived in. There was this big, scare going around that, this is actually true, that, you got to find a poofter. Poofter is more dangerous if he wants to go overseas than a terrorist. And that's the way it was in the 80s. We didn't have terror. Terror couldn't really survive or be done in the 1980s. The mindset was completely different, and there was no reason to terrorize anybody. It was good times. I know that's a bit controversial, but if you talk to people that grew up in the 1980s and were teenagers during the 1980s, they'll tell you that's most people will tell you that's right. Moving on. Neck pain. A lot of people woke up with neck pain and had bad neck pain, and I've been telling everybody that, you know, at work, because I've been doing this this research, and yet 2 days later I get neck pain myself, and the answer is just to take a Panadol or some type of relaxing pill. Alright, so the rotary engine. The rotary engine was very popular. Actually, it comes to mind now, the RX-7. Mazda RX-7 with the rotary was a very popular car. You don't see them anymore on the road at all. They might be in museums, or they may just be in the junkyard. I've got no idea what happened to them. Affordable cars and motorbikes. Yeah, now I'll tell you a story. When I was a young bloke, in about 1983, I was able to, during the school holidays, go out and work on a farm as a labourer for about a month and a half, and I'd have enough money to go out and buy a brand new motorcycle. I had a an RZ250 Yamaha. Swallowing a raw egg was very popular. Just to get an egg, crack it, and put it down the gullet and swallow it was very popular. Sunbaking, and I mean sunbaking, just putting oil all over yourself and just roasting yourself until you were red was very popular. Probably not healthy, but the idea was to get a tan, God knows why, and so that was the mentality. That was popular in that day. Bodybuilding was very popular, lifting weights and being all muscly. Male gayness. Now, when the 80s springs to mind, there was a lot of that around. Now, I know that in the USA, there was a big movement against that type of thing. And I remember quite a few bands from England. I don't mean any disrespect to English people whatsoever. However, in the USA, there was a move to sort of get those bands and bring them over to the USA and sort of man them up. That was just the sort of on the news and the television and stories that you heard. That was sort of what was going on. Female women's lib was huge in the 80s. Women's lib. It was all about women's lib, and you couldn't say, you could say this about women, you couldn't say that about women, and women's lib. Free education. Education was free. You know, you didn't have to pay. You could just go to TAFE or college. You didn't have to pay, and you could just sit in there in front of lectures, take notes, and go to college. Now, these are notes taken from the BBC Grumpy Old Women 1980s. Ultra rich. So there was a huge boom, and I mean really huge. A lot of people made a lot of money in the 1980s, and there was, for those that were in the game, there was a lot of money to be made and a lot of wealthy people. And then came the bust from memory. I think it was around about 88, 89. There was a huge share market bust, and then that led to the negative 90s and all that went with it. wealthy people, sort of people that could live it up, spend it up, and just treat money as if it grew on trees. The Rubik's Cube. There was a cube and you could twist it and turn it, and you had to line up all the colours on all the seven sides, I think. Six sides. The Rubik's Cube was very popular, as I say, and they used to actually have shows and contests who could be the fastest to work it out. With women, big belts, and also with men, it was popular to have a big belt, like a big buckle. Beads, they say in the BBC program that beads were popular. I can't remember it myself. Maybe that's because I was living in Australia. Hair, as I've said before, big buffed up, big hair, with mousse and put all stuff in it so that it stood up and all that sort of thing, or to be buffed up. Yeah, this is one of my notes. As I said before, at the time, if you lived in the 1980s, all this stuff was completely normal. Yes, there were fads and fashions. That's the thing about the 80s, was there were always fads and fashions coming through, and you could be a part of that or not be a part of that, and there were many, many different... it wasn't just the, the sort of the get-up and the dress-up. There were also people that followed the rock and, they've always been around, and much the same as they are now, but I digress. At the time when you were living in the 80s, it was all fairly normal. It's just in retrospect that you really can't believe your eyes. Earrings on men wore earrings, sometimes two, sometimes one, and apparently I'm told that it all depends on what ear it was in, whether you were gay or not, and all this sort of jazz. It wasn't my scene, but that's what I'm told, that meant things. In the 1980s, luckily for me, I suppose, in retrospect, I was the sort of person that just followed the, the normal guy type image, and, did I get sucked into a few tricks and cons from the 1980s? Yeah, sure, I bought some slightly risky albums. I might have been invited to a normal party, but I was told that it was a man had to dress up as a girl, and girls were to dress up as guys, and yes, I fronted up, and I got tricked in a few 1980s traps. But such is life. Allowable protesting. You could just get a group together and you could protest in the city about virtually anything. It wasn't as allowable as, say, the 60s or 70s, but it was still allowable at this time. Yeah, yuppies. Yuppies were rich people, young, up-and-coming, and... working in an office and you're a yuppie. That was a big thing. Much talked about topic. Yuppies and the hugely rich people. The two-stroke motor, very popular on especially motorcycles. Well, only motorcycles, really. All motocross bikes, small 80cc bikes up to 500cc's, they were all two-stroke, and you had a special class for four strokes, but... a lot of the quick bikes and new bikes on the road were two-stroke. Apparently boil-in-the-bag meals were popular. You had a bag, plastic bag, and had a meal in it. You'd throw it in the new microwaves that just came out at that time, and you'd have your meal there in a bag. I don't remember it myself, but apparently it was around. Puppets and ventriloquists were very popular in the 80s. I suppose that came from the 70s. Puppets and ventriloquists on late night programs or variety shows. And the variety show was very popular in the 1980s as well as the 70s. And a variety show was just everything. You'd have a compere, and he'd be sort of the main man of the program, and you'd have everything. You'd have interviews, topic discussions, dancing, music, just absolutely anything you can think of would be on variety shows, and they were fairly good. Cabbage Patch Dolls. If you Google any of these subjects, you'll find information. Cabbage Patch Dolls were quite ugly looking dolls that were hugely popular. And you could adopt one and fill in the paperwork, and it was all yours. Cassette tapes and Walkmans. Well, cassette tapes were really the only things that you could afford. And when CDs came out, incidentally, they were advertised as being absolutely indestructible. You could get a key and rip down on top of a CD and it wouldn't hurt it at all. Just keep on going. Yeah, cassette tapes and Walkmans. Okay. Yeah, so the first Walkmans that came out, you used to put your tape in it, and then later on Walkmans were released where you could use a CD. Remote controls, yep. Remote control your television, change the channel, the volume, that came out in the 80s from memory. Some TVs may have had them in the 70s, but from memory it was the 1980s where they originated. CB radio. CB radio came out in, I think, obviously the 70s, and at first, but they were popular in the 80s, actually, there was more advertising and warning about the dangers of a CB radio than the dangers of the internet, which is a very interesting thing. The internet being so dangerous with dating sites and all the rest of it. Really, any terrorist or bad-meaning person is right here at the lead coming out of your telephone cable instead of overseas or in another area. Yeah, the dangers of the CB radio. Digital watch came out. Digital watches were very popular. Divining. Divining is something you don't hear about anymore, but it was popular in the 80s. Now, the theory was you could get a stick with two ends, and the stick would go down to a point, like a sort of a Y design, and a person, a good diviner, would be able to just sort of walk around and get the feeling of where the water was, and you'd be able to put your stick down and the water would be there. Magic. Yeah, men dressed as women. Yeah, sure, there were men dressed as women in the 80s. They were very popular with a certain type of person. Men dressed as women. If you Google Divine or Boy George, you're going to know exactly what I'm talking about. In the 80s, you had mini everything. You had mini golf, from memory, mini cricket, everything. TV knife sets. You could buy a great big knife set, you know, a great big one this big with all different sorts of knives, you know, wavy knives, sharp knives, small knives, big knives, knives with, you know, ebony handles, black handles, metal handles, you know, and that's where this sort of weight, you know, there's more, you know, you also receive, and knife sets. The mini moke I'm going to leave out because I think the mini moke was popular in the 70s and not the 80s. I've covered the topic of cheap toys, you know, like cars and motorcycles being very affordable, as well as petrol being cheaper. Peeping Toms. Peeping Toms. A Peeping Tom was somebody who would sort of hang around the house, or somebody's house, not my house, because there's nothing to see. But a Peeping Tom would sort of find a female, I suppose, you know, and he'd try and sort of look at her at night and in the dark. That was a popular thing. You know, you'd hear stories and warnings about Peeping Toms in your area. Okay, so moving on, Bruce Springsteen, you know, the working class man. He was sort of up there, the top right-hand side of the USA type of man. Dire Straits are English. They were very popular. The song Girls Just Want to Have Fun by Cyndi Lauper. If you Google Girls Just Want to Have Fun, they also made a movie called Girls Just Want to Have Fun. Okay, this was a popular thing to do. Okay, so when somebody would stare at you like this, and you were that person there, you would wave your hand, you know, like that in front of the person's face, and to sort of wake them up. That was That was popular. It's just people don't do it anymore. Another trick you'd do with your friends was you'd poke your head out from a door, say the door would be here, you poke your head out and you bring your own hand up and sort of, it's as if somebody was grabbing you from behind. That was just something funny to do. Okay, so I've got a handful of sayings here, sayings from the 80s. Rad, that's rad or radical. You know, really good. Or get real. I suppose that's still used to some extent today. Tricked up, or trick, was a tricked up motorcycle, was sort of a motorcycle with modifications to make it go faster. And of course, dorks, the 1980s dork. You're a dork if you, I don't know what a dork is, type of awkward person, or you do things that aren't sort of cool, I suppose. Okay, so I've got two more pages to go. You can hang in there if you want. Rap dancing, of course, rap dancing was big in the 1980s, spinning around on your back and, twirling around. Dancing was extremely popular, and I suppose that stemmed from rap dancing. It was popular in the 90s as well. It's also popular now, but it was very popular in the 1980s. Cooking wasn't as popular as it is today. You know, you had all sorts. You had the microwave oven, and cooking was the least of your worries. Get off my case was a saying. To fill me in. You know, tell me what's going down. Hanging out. You would hang out somewhere. That's also from the 70s. Vegetate. You were vegetating if you just wanted to sort of go home and just do absolutely nothing, just sit in front of the television and vegetate. Couch potato. A couch potato is somebody that just like to sit on the couch and, watch TV. Check it out. To check something out. Well, I suppose that's still used to some extent today, but I think in a slightly different way. Big belts, as I've said before, with a big buckle and, big strap. Jumpers, parkas, without shoulders. So, and t-shirts, you'd have a t-shirt without a shoulder, and you had big woolen winter tops, jumpers, without a shoulder as well. Without, arms, I mean. Yeah, so t-shirts without sleeves. Yeah, that's right. Ripping a towel from underneath a meal. Yeah, there were a lot of tricks, and a lot of people tried to do it themselves at home, and everything went flying. It was on a lot of movies and teenage college comedy movies. You'd have a table, it'd be full of, drinks and a meal and plates and everything. And you'd have this trick where a person would come up, grab the cloth, the tablecloth, and rip it out in such a manner that everything would just stay there and wouldn't be ripped off with it. Acting goofy, like a bit of an idiot, I suppose. So acting goofy, you'd have these comedy movies and just college comedy movies from the USA. I think most of them were around the New York area. And, as a sort of sidekick, you'd have this goofy guy just saying and goofy things and acting in a goofy manner. Start of popular electronic music. There was, Farn 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 in die Autobahn, and from the 70s or very early 80s. There was some electronic music around in the early 70s, but it became extremely popular in around about 84, and then after 84, there was a new type of sound, and it was advertised, and you heard about this new type of sound coming through. And that was around about 85, and that's where you get that dun, 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 electronic sort of beat, and the 80s sort of riding with the pink and very bright colours. Riding escalators. Now, you don't have young people sort of going up and down and up and down the same escalator, but that was a fairly popular thing to do in the 80s, and you could get away with it for a short amount of time, but then of course security would come out and tell you to move on. Cindy Lauper, Cyndi Lauper was very popular in the 80s. Leg warmers. Leg warmers, girls used to wear leg warmers, and they were socks that went from sort of, if your shoe was here, the top of your shoe was there, the leg warmer would start there and go up to your thigh, and it was knitted out of wool or some type of material like that, and they were leg warmers. Dial, you could dial anything. You could pick up the phone book and you could see the numbers, and you could dial abuse, praise, you could dial, there were many things you could dial, and you just pick up the phone, you dial it, and you'd phone the phone number, and if you dialed abuse, you could, you know, somebody would pick up and they'd just say, you're a this and you're a that, and it's gone now. Peeping Toms, I've gone into Peeping Toms before on this talk. Stalkers. A stalker, there were a lot of stalkers around in the 1980s, and they'd be men and or young men, and they'd follow a woman around and just follow her around, stalkers. You don't hear very much of it anymore, but in the 1980s it was a very big problem. Being bored. Getting and being bored. You got to remember that in the 1980s, here in Australia where I lived, there were only 4 television stations and your radio stations. So there wasn't all that much to do. Now, there'd be times when you just wouldn't have anything to do on the weekends, and, you know, you'd get bored. But that doesn't happen anymore because you've always got something to do with the computer. Using big words was popular in the 80s. You know, you'd have, you sort of muck around with your friends and that, you know, the velocity of the income of the outgoing countryside was in proportionate to the amount of, you know, calligraphy within the operating system, you know. The 1950s was very popular in the 1980s. So 50, 60, 70, 80. We've probably got the same thing now. The 80s are popular in the 2000s and 10s. So sort of this 30-year time frame behind which you live. Nevertheless, 1950s was popular and for fairly good reason. And 1950s was quite a straight type of strong culture. And the 80s was pretty much the opposite. And so it was for good reason the 50s was popular in the 80s. Hair mousse and gel. You could get mousse, you could rub it in your hair, and it would make your hair all buffy, and, you know, look, no doubt a lot of females and women would be, they'd know about mousse and where to get the mousse and that for your hair. Gel was also popular. Gel had a straightening effect, so you could get your hair. I think Green Day, the singer from Green Day, use gel, so that sort of standing up type of haircut, gel. Now, one person that, as far as I can tell, has just completely disappeared from history is Huey Lewis and the News. Huey Lewis and the News. I want a new drug, and he was very 1980s. He was sort of a little bit like, it wouldn't surprise me if he was Californian. He was a little bit like Van Halen, that type of fresh, you know, good attitude type of singer and music, but I don't know where he's gone. I haven't heard anything from him whatsoever in a long, long time. Okay, I'm up to my last page now. You Spin Me Right Round, Like a Record Baby, that that singer, that was a big type of a, what'd you say, big shock, you know, like you'd see this guy, and a lot of people are very sort of shocked by it even now. Now, what do I think of it? Well, I think that a lot of stuff we listen to is going to be gone, and You Spin Me Right Round is still going to be around in a very long time. I don't personally want to put a picture of this guy up, but he did make a very big impact. You Spin Me Right Round. You can Google a song. It's a song. You can Google it if you wish. saying moi instead of me was popular. I suppose one of the biggest mysteries to me is how we went from the 1980s to the 1990s. You know, was it the media? Probably. Was it, you know, consequences of the share market crash of the 1980s, the late 1980s? Possibly. Possibly, with the lack of money and, I don't know, poverty, that type of thing. But I've got a feeling that the 1990s led to the terrorism movement. Yeah, as I've said before, get real was a saying, you know, oh, get real, you know, if you thought somebody wasn't being fair dinkum or real. The saxophone. Saxophone was massive in the 1980s, possibly because of the 50s using the saxophone, and I know I've heard recently that the saxophone is coming back into popularity. This guy Huey Lewis, I think he had a lot of saxophones in his music. Yeah, the saying, one of the sayings was to pack, or I packed, I was scared. My God, you know, I nearly crashed my motorbike, you know, I was packing, you know. As I've said before, you know, did I fall for any of the traps of the 1980s? Of course I did. You know, I purchased a few risky albums and went to a few fancy dress parties that I got sucked into, I suppose. And that's, you know, as I've said before, that's life. You've got to remember that was a fashion of the time and, you know, to just sort of deal with it, I suppose. Okay, a thing you would say was if somebody sort of stood out or was done something different, you would say to them, you're not from around here, are you? Or, you know, excuse me, mate, he doesn't get out too much. Okay, I'm coming to the end of my talk. I'm doing all of this in one go. A lot of the other talks I do throughout the week. Bummer, was something bad? Oh, bummer. 1980s, it wasn't as popular as it is now to protect yourself. A lot of the building stuff you see I make, you know, I'm promoting wearing glasses to protect your eyes, earplugs to protect your ears or earmuffs, you know, wearing gloves and all the rest of it. It wasn't as popular in the 80s. It was fairly sort of gung-ho, you know, just get the job done. But believe me, there are a few eyes lost and, you know, limbs cut off because people didn't take the time to protect themselves, especially if you're a tradesman and even the home, you know, handyman. Okay, so just four more things I'd like to talk about now. Wouldn't touch it with a 10-foot pole. You know, you really don't like something, you really don't like that person. I wouldn't touch that motorbike with a 10-foot pole that's been thrashed and it's been sort of flooded out and been sitting in water, that type of thing. The Loch Ness Monster, I believe that with all the satellites and monitoring devices and all the rest of it, they'd be able to easily proof whether the Loch Ness Monster is real or fictional. I believe it's fictional, but the Loch Ness Monster was very popular in the 80s. Yeah, so the last one is the 1980s was from 1984 to 1988, and it ended with a share market crash the late 80s, approximately 1989. One of the most unique and different and good bands that ever came out of the 1980s was a band called Talk Talk. They were from England and they had a very, very different sound to anything that was made in the 1980s. They were probably following their own people that they looked up to. Google Talk Talk. That's good music. So that's it. I've got to say that the 1980s talk was, you know, I enjoyed it. It was a pleasure.